Welcome back, students. Let us start with the second chapter, The Thief Story. A short biography on the author, Ruskin Bond, born on 19th May 1934, is an Indian author of British descent. He lives with his adopted family in Landur, Missouri, India. The Indian Council for Child Education has recognized his role in the growth of children's literature in India. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 for Our Trees Still Grow in Dera, his novel in English. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 and the Padma Bhushan in 2014. Now let us start with the story. The story starts from the point where the two main characters of the story meet, Anil and the thief. The thief is the narrator of the story. The thief says that, according to him, he was pretty good at stealing. Anil was watching a wrestling match when the thief approached him. Anil was tall, lean, and an easygoing man of 25 years. The thief had not committed any theft in the past few days, as he did not get a chance. He thought that Anil would be a good man to steal things from. So he thought about getting comfortable with him. Then the thief commented on Anil that he looked like a wrestler himself. He said that to win his confidence by flattering him. To this, Anil replied that even the thief looked like a wrestler, which offended him, as he was very thin at that time. The thief modestly replied that he did wrestle a bit sometimes. Anil asked his name, and the narrator replied that his name was Hari Singh. The narrator used to change his name every month to escape the police and these ex-employers. Then they started talking about the well-oiled wrestlers whom they watched on the screen. The narrator did not have much to say, as he did not know much about wrestling. As Anil was leaving, the narrator again approached him, asking him that he wanted to work for him. The narrator approached him with the most appealing smile that he could. Anil told him that he won't be able to pay him for his work. Hari had not expected this reply and thought to himself that he had misjudged Anil, as he had thought that Anil had a lot of money. The narrator then asked if he could feed him, to which Anil instantly asked if Hari could cook. Hari lied again and said yes. Anil replied that if Hari could cook, then he could feed him. Both of them went to Anil's room, which was above the Jumna sweet shop. Anil also told Hari that he could sleep in the balcony. The narrator said that the meal that he cooked must have been terrible, as Anil had to give it away for the stray dogs. Then he told Hari to go and sleep, but Hari decided to stay for a while. Hari's smile was so appealing that Anil could not stop laughing looking at him. After some time, Anil patted on Hari's head and told him that he would teach him to cook. He also told him how to write his name, and told him that he would soon teach him to write sentences and add numbers. Hari was grateful for what Anil had planned, as he knew that there would be no limits to his work once he knew how to write. Hari enjoyed working for Anil. He used to make tea for him in the morning and then used to go out to buy groceries for the day. He would also keep 1 rupee in his pocket every day from the money that Anil used to give him for daily groceries. Anil knew that he took a rupee every day, but he did not mind. He was fine with it. Anil did not have any regular income as he used to earn money by doing different activities. He did not have any fixed job. The narrator says that Anil used to be worried about his paychecks all the time, but as soon as he would receive a check, he would go out with his friends and celebrate. The narrator thinks that he used to write for magazines. The narrator also thinks it to be a strange way to make money. Then suddenly one evening, Anil came home with some money and told Hari that he had just sold a book to a publisher. Before going to bed, Anil put money under his mattress and Hari saw him putting the money there. Hari thought that he had been working for Anil for almost a month now and he had not cheated him apart from the 1 rupee that he used to take out daily. The narrator also thinks that he had every chance to steal as Anil had given him the key to his room as well as and he could come and go whenever he wished to do so. Hari had been trusted upon by Hari the most. Hari had not been trusted upon by anyone else in his life. This was the only thing that was stopping Hari from stealing, as Hari thought that it is way easy to rob a greedy man because he has the capability or the money to get robbed as he knows about what he has lost. But for a careless man like Anil, there was no use to steal as they sometimes don't even come to know that they have been robbed. Also, Hari feels that when someone doesn't come to know that he has been robbed, then there is no fun left in robbing him. Then Hari decided that he would start with some work. He had not robbed anyone for a long time. He also justified his act of stealing Anil's money by telling himself that he didn't steal it. Then also Anil would waste it on his friends. He also thought that he had a right over the money as Anil didn't expect even pay him for the work he used to do. Hari started his work when Anil was sleeping. There was a little bit light over Anil's bed because of the moonlight that was coming in from the window. Hari sat on the floor and planned that if he took the money, he could leave the city by the 10:30 p.m. Lucknow Express train. Hari then crawled towards the bed and slipped his hand slowly inside the bed mattress. He looked at Anil, who was sleeping peacefully without a single line on his face, and Hari's face had so many scars on it. He realized that although he was much younger than Anil, he had such a bad appearance due to his wrong thinking. On the other hand, Anil was carefree and thought good for others, because of which he had such a nice face. Hari then took out the notes without making any sound. Anil took a breath in his sleep and turned his side. He was directly facing Hari, which scared him a bit, and Hari quickly left the room. As soon as Hari left the room and was on... As soon as Hari left the room and was on the road, he started running and had kept the notes in his pajamas. He had tied it with a string of pajamas. Then after a while, Hari slowed down and counted the notes. He had 12 notes of 50 rupees each, which made it 600 rupees. Then Hari thought to himself that with this much money, he could live a luxurious life like an Arabian sheikh for at least 2 weeks. When Hari reached the station, he straight away went to the platform without buying a ticket, as he had never bought a ticket in his life. He had always travelled without a ticket. When he reached the platform, the Lucknow Express in which he had to go was just leaving the platform. The train was still slow, so he could have easily jumped and got on one of the carriages. But he did not do so. There was a bit of hesitation in him. Even he didn't understand why he had the hesitation inside him, and because of that he could not board the train. After some time, when the train had left, Hari found himself as all alone at the empty platform. Hari did not know where would he spend the night. He did not have any friends whom he could go to, as he used to think that friends were more of a trouble than being helpful. He did not even want to stay in small hotels, as that would attract attention. He knew only one person very well and he had robbed him as well. As Hari was walking through the bazaar, after leaving the station, he was thinking of his observations as a thief. In a short career span, he had realized that although everybody from rich to poor shows different reaction to losing their goods, but Anil would only be a little sad. That too would not be because he lost his money, but because he has lost trust that he had on Hari. He would be sad that he trusted someone so much and the person had betrayed him. Hari was walking when he reached a park. He sat on the bench as it was the month of November. The night was a bit chilly and then the drizzle added to the discomfort that Hari was going through. It started raining quite heavily and Hari's shirt and pajamas stuck to his body. Cold wind was blowing across Hari's face. Then Hari went back towards the bazaar and sat under the shelter of the clock tower to escape getting wet. It was 12 o'clock. By the clock tower, Hari checked the notes and they were wet. Then again Hari started thinking that it was Anil's money and if he had not stolen it, Anil would have surely given him 2 to 3 rupees to go for a movie. But now as he had stolen it, he had it all. Now he won't be able to make tea or do groceries for Anil anymore, nor would be able to learn to write whole sentences ever. He had not realized that he would be losing so many things in the excitement of stealing the money. He knew that if he could learn to read and write, he could earn much more money than these few hundred rupees, and that too honestly. He knew that it was very easy to steal something from someone, but sometimes it was that easy to get caught as well. He knew that if he learned to read and write, he would surely become a big and a respected man one day. Then Hari told himself that he should go back if he wanted to learn to read and write, and also if he wanted to be a big man one day. Hari went back to Anil's room and he was very nervous because he knew that it was much more difficult to return stolen things without being caught than actually stealing it. Hari went to the hallway and stood there as the moonlight was still falling over the bed. Anil was still asleep. Hari went near the head of the bed and took out the notes. As he was going near the mattress, his hand could feel Anil's breath on his hand. Hari became still for a moment, found the edges of the mattress and finally slipped the notes under it. The next morning, Hari woke up a little late. He woke up very little late and Anil had already made the tea by then. Anil extended his hand towards Hari and handed a 50 rupee note in his hand. Hari thought he had been caught. Then suddenly Anil explained that he had made some money the day before, so he was giving him 50 rupees. He also said that he would be paying Hari regularly. Hari was really happy, but when he took the note in his hand, he saw that it was still wet from last night. He also told Hari that day he would teach him how to write complete sentences. Hari realized that Anil had come to know that he had stolen the money and kept it back. But the great thing that happened was that he did not let it show on his face or his words. Hari realized that Anil had come to know that he had stolen money and kept it back. But the great thing that happened was that he did not let it show on his face or his words. Hari again smiled at Anil in his most appealing way, and Anil's smile also came to its face without any efforts. This was the story The Thief by Ruskin Bond all about. Thank you for listening.